tires put on the tractor. Keen observer will note the tires are already on there. Well, this is my third try at this video. I bought a wireless mic to try and improve my audio on the videos. You know, if it's not compatible. So I'll buzz you through a little footage of getting these tires mounted, and we'll get the weights on next. Wheel weights are held on with these two carriage bolts. There's one on each side that has a hole in it for a cotter pin to hold it in there while you're trying to wrestle that heavy weight on. We'll get them on next. Directly across from it, you can install one of the other ones. Went on a lot easier than I thought it would. I originally wasn't going to put the weights back on here because I really don't need them, but what better place to store them than right there? And start putting some of the linkages together over here. Do the hand clutch first. There's no grease arc on there, but I greased the shaft up. That's about all the lube that's ever going to get. Washer and cotter pin in there. The linkage for the hand clutch can go on. pin's installed, that's done. Next we'll put on the actuator for the parking brake. Handle for that goes up through this bracket. You just pull up on it to engage the parking brake. Washer on there and a cotter pin. Install the brake, clutch pedal next. A little grease in there for that. That's how the parking brake works. I can't do the right hand brake yet because the frame rail has to go on first. That pedal actually goes on the outside of the frame rail. Now the clutch pedal can go on. And now the linkage for the clutch can go on. Get a couple cotter pins for that. Now the brake rod can go in for this side. The bell crank. Now this side's complete with the exception of the spring for the brake pedal. We're ready for the frame rail to go back on this side. I went ahead and temporarily installed this brake pedal for the time being. There's no cotter pins in there yet. The frame rail will go right through here. So this is as far as I can go for this side because I got linkage to go to the hydraulic valve. But I need the snap coupler to go back on the bottom for that, which is still at the sandblasters. So as soon as I get that back, I can start reassembling the snap coupler, the PTO, get the linkage for the PTO on, and then we'll be ready for the frame rail on this side. That's going to do it for this video until I get some more parts in. I'm kind of at a standstill. Hope you enjoyed it. Big old thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. While you're doing that, make sure you check out Zane at Hodgepodge Dodge Garage, James at Third Coast OBS, and Cody at White Dock Productions. They all have great channels, a lot of good content. Catch you next time.